Hi, Paul Howe, CSAT Way. Wanted to do a quick segment on gear and how you look and how you dress. And what happens is we get a lot of students coming to class now. They're worried about the problems that are happening in America. Now, a lot of people are going out and buying the body armor. Well, body armor is a big target unless you have police on there, security, or something like that. You know, once you put this on over the top, you're a big target. And that's simple as it is. Now, you can't get it off fast enough, and so where could you use this? Well, if you're doing low viz hits, you're law enforcement, you bet. You know, pop out, but you still want to be marked in a uniform. So as a civilian, really, maybe home defense. You might want to think about that. So what happens is, think about when you're going to wear it, how you're going to deploy it. If you leave it in your vehicle, it's now a target for thieves. You got to put a lot of thought into it. Before you go to all this level, you may want to invest in a little bit of training first, and then figure out what scenarios this would apply to. So the other thing is we've got the rifles, and now we're in civilian clothes and we've got a rifle hanging off us. The problem that this is, again, you're a big target. Once it comes out, it's hard to get it off or hard to cache. And what cache means is to quickly hide it in a discreet manner that you can go back and recover it later if you need to. But once this weapon is out and it's on you, then the issues arise. Police say, put up your hands. What do you do? All right, drop the weapon. Well, you can. It's on a sling. So there's a problem there, and you got to think through all these scenarios when you're going to actually come out and deploy this. And what happens is it's got to be a thought-out process. Now, what happens is I like to buy, I won't call it, frumpy clothes. And when I say frumpy clothes, I wear hats that don't say CSAT, you know, kill them all, let God sort them out kind of stuff. I want to be neutral. I don't have any 550 cord. Right now I don't have any tattoos. So what happens is I wear generic clothes that I can blend in. I can solve a problem and blend back in. And so what happens is I can walk into the woods with this type of apparel and kind of lay down and you won't see me. So you got to think through the whole process. I can keep all my weapon systems concealed. Yes, it's not tight fitting. I buy a little bit bigger, and you got to think about your platforms and how you layer your equipment so that way you can employ it and get back into a neutral visual. What does that mean? Well, one block may be hot and a lot of stuff going on. You can walk a block away in a big city and it's low viz. It's just like day to day. So what happens is you have to be able to go from high threat to low viz that quick. And again, you got to be prepared to do that and reconceal. So we teach it to a lot of our classes. Don't be standing there caught out there with a gun, because now it's a 360 degree battlefield. Once you get this on, it's hard to get off. Once you get this out, it's hard to hide or cache. So think about this in your tactical training and ask your instructors, you know, what ifs, when can, and when you can apply all this to your tactical situations. So I hope this helps you and stimulates a little bit of thought. So you take care, be safe, and I will catch you on the range or on the Patreon website.